jijimi Oye nye mebidi jijimi Ode makumebo chaskele Onya mirema miyunadini Sumsum pesu huna miye mire 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 Obintu nifuma miye Naza mitinkinze ya Weni meba uza na ketro Obimeji mema wesuwe
Obidi ya kroku obejimi
Obeji memu wenye uwe
Ode nisika benjimi
Wanka Samanka,
Obedia
Crocro, Betchimi,
Eh,
Wanka and Timami Dre,
Ordin Sika, Betchimi,
Obedia Crocro, Betchimi,
Obedia Crocro, Betchimi,
Obedia Wanka Samanka,
Obedia
Crocro, Betchimi, Eh, Wanka Sika, Betchimi, Odokra, Sika, Kakra, and Mareka in my hair. Naze muni bina wonya mrema mimpwa Nimeji wate Odo minye chali wate Inti mame ninji wate Iye vivya kawate Sebu mpado mejayo Sebu jame sebu suma Ziyubi befami ako baby Intu vema upia befami Odo sebu mpemi ya jame Mi huwa mane Makumasho don se mamame Una munye jenti pe mi ne suso mi mu Se buja mi se kwenti fia Si drenyi mre na mami nkwa mi da Se mi so mu na juji mu hua Enye se wara o wara mi dre Obi meji mi ama wesu e
Obidi ya kroku obeji mi
Obeji mi amu weni e uwe
Odi nisika obeji mi
Rena wanka se manka
Obidi ya kroku obeji mi
Wanka nti mami dre
Odi nisika
Obi njue, nankeva shimi, ni pari yambumzua wa yonzi mafungwa vachemi wakosia Minye bimla, odomi siya siya sana ya bongo mwa papa Zemi ni mbibi ya ka, mini mbibi ya, njua misani ya mene wenante Ayosa uwa ya bibi wa mechimide, evani seba shimi papa, odie ya shimi papa Fina koi na ne imajimi mpumzu hatu Ubi di ni nkomo vejiu Anke pa shimi ya shimi ya shimi Kepo nili ya majibi ya na meze sama umide Bengo pe ubi ya uwe
Ubi meji mi ama wesu e
Ubi di ya kroku obeji mi
Obeji mi amu we ni uwe
Odi nisika obeji mi
Rena wanka se manka
Ubi di ya kroku obeji mi
Wanka nti mami dre
Odi nisika obeji mi
Rena wanka se manka
Obidi ya kroku obeji mi
Rena wanka se manka
Odi nisika obeji mi
Rena wanka se manka
Obidi ya kroku obeji mi
Rena wanka se manka
Odi nisika obeji mi
Siria Shemanu, Enigia Shemakumemu, Wakasim did it be a good masum.
Shed your diamond,
or Pippa Marewonina, or him, mammy, did you Mudenkoa, and Sichinia won or did Kumi.
Shed your diamond,
shed your diamond, yeah.
Shed your diamond,
shed your diamond, yeah.
Shed your diamond.
Made me so beautiful.
Shed your diamond.
Made my life so meaningful.
Shed your diamond.
Midian coming to me, baby. I'm a dreamy home. Many the swan in a sun. Nan come see me, no be more. We say, order pa, and we in a pa. Masha, shasha, shami, yapido. Semiti nka Mama kuma mu Nka vini Yesi odo Ah, miyem shimipa Ebo mihu Frise mati mati Yesi odo eti akuma But you gave me a reason To let you stay My life never been the same since the day. Oh, I will never ever let you go. I will never ever let you go. I will never ever let you go. Oh, dear serious, Shema, no. And it's your Shema, come and move. What can't seem to be a good muscle.
Shed your tie me.
What people are my reward, you know. What he mommy teach you, Mutanko. It's a chain you want to call me.
Shed your tie 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 me.
Oh, you made me so beautiful.
Shed your tie me.
Made my life so meaningful.
Shed your tie me.
It's another Friday, and as usual, today's show is about people. Now, I love people. I love people. People are fascinating. People are excited. But there's a catch. I always bring you even more exciting and fascinating people. Today is no exception. I have my sister in the house. You see, I have my sister in the house. I'm chatting today with Dzifa Gray. I would not even attempt to introduce her. She's eloquent and up to the task, so I'm going to leave you back.
I try my
to
best
to introduce herself. Dzifa, welcome.
Hey,
to the
thank
couch.
You so much. And Ama, thank you so much for having me. Indeed, we are sisters, Ama. You remember the first time we met, right?
Yes.
And I make sure that wherever I go, mm. I mean, whoever I meet, mm. I know that sometimes it says chemistry.
Yeah.
But it's up to you to create that chemistry.
Yeah.
And so I stay positive. So wherever I go, I have to make sure that, look, I build a relationship, mm. not because of whatever I'm going to get, but because there's tomorrow. And Ama, indeed, we are sisters. And I pray that whatever problems we have in the future, mm. you tell me, Dzifa, mimpenye wuye no. Now tell you, mami lema kwana mendri. What else here?
Mami lema
home. But thank you so much for letting me come on your show.
I'm excited. You know, I started dragging you like 2 weeks ago.
It's true, yes.
Two weeks ago. And I'm happy that you finally
thank you.
Finally
thank you. It's
made
an
it.
Honor to be here.
Thank
Ama.
You for coming. How do you find my couch? How
look,
do you find it?
Ama, you know, look, I like pictures on, I am TV host, but I like pictures on Facebook, Instagram, and all that, okay? Mm. And the thing is, when I see great touch, unique, you know, ideas, creativity put to life, mm. I will not hesitate. Whether you are the best TV host and I am not, I will like your page, you know, because it's not easy putting things together.
It's not.
You can dream about it. A lot of people are dreamers. They dream. Mm. But to actually bring it to reality is another thing altogether. Now, mm. I must say that I commend you and your husband and the whole family of Pan African because you guys have done incredibly
thank
well.
Thank you, Dzifa. Coming from you, I take that as a compliment. Thank you so much.
Welcome,
Dzifa. Tell me about yourself. Who is Dzifa Gray?
I don't know where to start, but I'm sure that Ghanaians actually noticed me on Tales from the Powder Room
yes.
with Nasho Call. Hi, Na. And then,
well, hi, Na.
Yes. And then after that, I think that because I was open to whatever, you know, conversation that comes up, and I get myself involved in whatever it is that we talk about, because I think in life you'd have to share your real experience to make a difference. Because I mean, this year's Women International Day is about being bold for change, okay? Mm. But how can you be bold for change when you're not real?
True.
And so that's how I laid myself to Ghanaians, and honestly, look, it's worked for me because that's what I've always wanted. That is why I'm in the industry. That is why I'm in front of the cameras, and that's why I'm on a show like yours, and an exclusive one like yours. And so Dzifa is just a real person. I have been through quite a lot. I mean, it might be, you know, little to somebody, but it's a lot to me. I have two siblings. I have parents. I lost my mother at age 18, and my father left 3 months after my mom was buried and left us with my grandparents. And so I grew up with my grandparents, okay? And so last year I lost my grandmother. And so it's been that journey, you know, when you this is Ghana, Africa, when you grow up with your grandparents, they know the sort of training you get. But I was quite a stubborn person.
No, I was.
I mean, you have to be, don't you?
No. Yeah, you do.
You have to be.
I think that's, look, in every child there is that stubbornness, but some of them hide it. But I was so real from a very early age. Mm-hmm. And I think that my mom's death really affected me because it just happened like that. You know, my mom died in my arms on the way to the hospital. And so we got to Kolebu, and then they brought my mom's stuff. And this is me asking, where is my mother? And I think that it took me a very long time to actually digest it well. Mm. And I think that the treatment from my father leaving us, let me tell you a story.
Tell me
this
a
is
story.
An exclusive.
Tell me a
so
story.
So you know how, I know viewers, you know how, wow, life. Okay, so my father, the very day he was leaving us, okay, he said he was gonna go, he was traveling, he would be back, okay. So he gave my sister, normally he would give my sister some money to buy fish and stuff for cooking. Me, you can't really, my father and I, we had our issue because he was stubborn, I'm stubborn too, and I tell him to his face, like, not disrespectfully, but you know, it's no, you were wrong, you are my father, I'm your daughter, we have that relationship, so let me tell you, you know, like, son, I'm sure you have a great relationship with your father. Yeah. And I was the type that he would chase with belt, and I'd say, hey, Papa, I can see you in the corner. You know, stuff like that.
Hey, check yourself.
So my father gave my sister money for fish and everything. And I just saw my son, and I'm distracted. But I'm sure we'll bring him on the
show.
We'll bring him on the show. And so, and then my father gave my sister money for fish and stuff. And then he said, okay, you know, it's not that expensive.
No.
And so my sister made that soup, you know, cooked the soup. And then they play, and then we ate. And that was it. It's a sikaudi jaya for how many years, no? And in the odi ton namono. And in the odi kak plan, odi yami bruni. So that is it. So how can you leave your kids with just that? At least they would jaya, oh, kokra, oh, they prepare bibi. What you see?
No. Wait. Hold up. So that was it.
That was it. And so I didn't understand.
Did he tell you that he was leaving?
No, he said he was traveling. He'll be back. So 2 days, 3 days. And so for after that, we didn't see my father again. And everybody was thinking. So this is me thinking. How are you? Okay, fine. You want to leave. Even if there's problem at home with, you know, you, everybody has family issues and all that. But don't leave your kids like that. And so it was a problem we had with him. But you know what? I think that my father came to us, I mean, 3-4 years ago, to apologize to my sister, my siblings, and myself. And he really apologized seriously that he's sorry for what he did. But you see, it won't take away the scar. But I want to progress. So there is no way I'm going to keep that. But it's a story I want you to know, because a lot of, you know, children, girls, youth are going through that. Parents leave their children without thinking that, look, this child, regardless of everything you don't have, everything you want to have and you don't have it in life, they need you around. And that's all we needed. We needed our father around because we knew that there's no money at home, but the fact that Papa will fear to be, yeah, you know, stuff like that. But it wasn't like that for us. So it
did affect. How old were you when this happened?
I was 18. Yeah. And so, you know, it's 18 is the time to jigga. You know, if you don't really have anybody around, that's the time, the clubbing days.
Oh, my goodness.
The way I club.
I can't even.
And you know
what?
I go to the club and I don't want to dance with anybody. And, you know, because of what my father did, I had an issue with men.
I can understand.
So when
that.
I go to the club, I go with my girlfriends. And so when you are a man and you want to dance with me, it's a problem. I'll fight with you on the dance floor.
I can't.
But there's this
you.
Guy that I met, and we've been good friends till today. And trust me, he really fought to dance with me on, you know, on the dance floor. But it didn't really work out. But we became friends. He followed me home, and he said, "Hey, you're a hard girl." I said, "Ah, what did you pay my gate fee for me? I want to come and dance." You know. So I love music and I love dancing, and it was one of the ways that I actually, you know,
you
get and all that.
The stress at
exactly.
home.
Exactly. So. That
wow, if
yeah.
I didn't know that about you.
Yeah, so it's an exclusive for
I didn't
you.
Know that, but that's like another layer to your character, isn't it?
It is, because you know what? I think that I'm recovering. I'm not there yet, but I am. And I think that I would have to do it to benefit my children. Now I have a beautiful, gorgeous...
Oh, he's gorgeous.
Amazing son.
He's gorgeous.
And his sense of humor is amazing. My son is definitely a great gift property from God, and if I don't impact positivity in him, it will be a problem for him as well. And because he hears me say all these things, so I would have to say show it the other way around, which is positively. Are you crying, Ama?
Oh, Dzifa.
Oh my God. You know, I was tearing, but Ama is wearing her Gucci glasses, so you can't.
This is my sister.
Ama, please, I beg you, don't cry. Ama, we have to be strong.
But you are strong.
I try to be. Look, it's. I cry, you know. I go through my very terrible times.
You are really strong.
And apart from that, what else? I had some terrible encounters, you know, when I was growing up.
Mm-hmm.
There was a time I wasn't home, and I, you know, you when you're out there and everybody wants to take advantage of you, and I that was when I had to pull that energy of, you know, being a man and some kind of beast, you know, because I don't want people taking advantage of me, especially men. You know, you definitely get into that encounter where one or two will take advantage of you, and it is the truth. If anybody tells you, look, nobody, I'ma stop crying, please. I wish I come. I was if I'm in someone proper when
you know, let's talk.
And people definitely take advantage of you, especially when you don't really know how to recover, when you have a problem and you think that they care and they just taking advantage. And there are a lot of people in this world like that. And so it's very important for you to have that kind of, you know, shelf where nobody can come close. You know, you have a shelf where nobody can you dare not come close. I will slap, I'll give it to you, you know. And so I have that, but it's not the, I don't like that. But it's a protection
it's necessary, isn't it? It's necessary as women. I think that sometimes, you know, we are fixated on being soft.
I'm a bro.
My sister. It's true. Sometimes we want to be soft. Everybody wants to be the adorable, you know. Somebody told me something some time ago when I was doing my national service at Ghana Commercial Bank, and the secretary there, she said to me, as a woman, if you are hard, you can't be loved. And so as a woman, it's important that you be soft. But it's also important that sometimes you be strong, isn't it, Dzifa? And when I look at you, I see that. But guess what?
Please tell me.
You are also soft.
I am extremely soft.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know, but so, I mean, there's this guy that I'm seeing. I don't know whether I'm seeing him or not. I don't know, but I think he really, really cares. And I have some good, positive people around me, and they're telling me, really, you can't see. And I feel like I'm not giving him a chance because I am too strong. But the days that I want to be nice, I am nice. And I feel like, hey, mommy,
let's talk about how you got into TV, because you are right.
Yeah.
I mean, you did start off with Tales from a Powder.
Yeah.
But how did that translate into your own show?
You know,
and Metro TV.
It all started. And you are hosting one of the exclusive shows right here on Pan African. Look, it all started with my son.
Okay.
My son being on Earth is a whole incredible.
Oh wow.
Incredible.
Look at
for me. And I think that it was a way that God, you know, was trying to heal me. And because everything I asked when I was pregnant and all that I was going through during pregnancy really revealed positively when I had my son. So, you know, I had issues with my relationship when I was pregnant and everything, things I experienced, but it's past and gone, and I'm over it now. And now, you know, now he's 8 now. And so after I had my son, I mean, I was home doing nothing, and then my friends, you know, would be like, ah, Dzifa, would you I done for 4 so by the way, a lawyer, and that's why I want to read law. But I
you
don't
should
know
because read law.
I should read. You court should. The way I throw you people should. Into jail.
Really,
I mean, if they are wrong, I will.
You should read law.
You know, stuff like that. But honestly, my friends would be like, Dzifa, you're cool like that. Why don't you host a show? So I started hosting a show in the house, which was called the Titi Gray Talk Show, in my living room.
Titi Gray
Talk Show.
Your name is Titi.
My mom's middle name is Titi.
It's a lovely name, by the way.
Thank you. And so I started that in the living room with my son in his, you know, cult and stuff like that. And my friend Josephine will help with him whilst I host the show. And so my son was my motivation, because after, you know, when you go through childbirth, it's another thing altogether. Is me in labor or saying that, God, after I have this kid, I am going to serve you for the rest of my life. You know, it's when you're going through pain and you remember God. It was that experience. And so when my son came through, I was like, look, I'm going to make sure that I really make a great impact. And with positive friends like Vivian Boyne, who is now a barrister in London, and what's her name? Josephine, and the others. And so I started a show in my living room.
This was in London.
And after 3 years, I rebranded it to the Dzifa Gray Modern Africa Show. And it was hosting celebrities from, you know, Ghana, Africa. I had Shirley from Pomanso, all the Adam's Apple, when they came to London, I had them. I mean, celebrities from all over Africa. And also hear true stories on the show, because it was mainly based on real true stories where people come to share it so others can learn out of. Mm-hmm. And then I decided to come to Ghana because my grandparents were here, they were growing and stuff like that. And I said, no, mm-hmm. I have to be around. I've been away, you know, in Kratasem and all that.
Are you going to buy the papers?
Over there. So immediately I got it. I said, hey, put me bashia. home sweet home. I came with my son and then met my family, and I was excited. I said, look, I want to stay because I can't leave my grandparent here, you know. They were there for me and all that. And so I started, you know, when I came, GH1 said, okay, fine, Dzifa, look, come on. But I did a few bits and pieces, the VGMA diaries with GH1 and all that. And then after, Apefa said, look, Dzifa, be a permanent guest on the on Tales from the Powder Room. And that's how it started. So television was built in me because of all that I've been through. And I thought that it's one way, it's, you know, television is powerful.
It is powerful.
And it's one way that I can share everything that I've been through and how I can, you know, one way that I can also impact it into our youth's life. And so, and I'm sitting here on
sitting on the couch. On the couch.
My one will be on the noise. It's so super.
Dzifa, we are on TV. Well, viewers, viewers, this is what happens when you bring your sister on your show.
Hey, Ama, you've been crying.
This is what happens. Well, we'll go for a quick break at this point. She hasn't even scratched the story yet. So please stay tuned. Quick commercial break. We'll be right back.
It's a beautiful day, I'm gonna make most of it. It's a beautiful day, a day to share with you. You'll make my world go round, yeah, yeah, yeah. It's really got me saying, nice girl.
Experience the wide range of top quality and affordable electronics, phones, tablets, home and office appliances from NASCO. NASCO, bring home happiness.
Hey, Jay. Ready? Everybody feel the Rasta. Yes. Rasta Choco Mod. Try and see.
Oh, me want some more.
Oh, Grandpa. That everybody can drink Rasta.
Oh, Ben Chaleno, give me some.
Yeah, everyone loves it. Rasta Choco Malt, truly refreshing malt to drink.
Should you die in me?
Or people are my real one, you know.
Hey, mommy, did you move then? Koa, is it any one or the kumi?
Shed your diamond,
shed your diamond, yeah.
Shed your diamond,
shed your diamond, yo.
Shed your diamond,
you made me so beautiful.
Shed your diamond,
made my life so meaningful.
Shed your diamond,
made you come to me, baby. I'm a dreamy home, many the swan in a sun. Nan come see me, no be more. We say, order pa, and we in a pa. Shasha, shasha, me, ya, be done. Kokim semi, unka, woma kuma mo, in cabini. You see, odo, ah, me, I'm shiba. Me who said, Mati, Mati, I see your door, Tia Kuma. But you gave me a reason to let you stay. My life's never been the same since that day. Oh, I will never ever let you go. I will never ever let you go. I will never ever let you go. Oh, dear serious, I know. And it's just a makume mu. Wakasem de debye gumasu.
Shed your diamond.
Wapipa mare wonyina. Wahima mi dichi mudenkuwa. Esi chenye wono dikumi.
Shed your diamond.
Shed your diamond, yeah.
Shed your diamond.
Shed your diamond, yo.
Shed your diamond.
Oh, you made me so beautiful.
Shed your diamond,
made my life so meaningful.
Shed your diamond.
Made my coming in a chewofa. Mimi asini na shawunsa, wudi sika mpiti ya shemensa. Iti ene megana mada. Uma mitimu ye mido, ujichimi suma mifili shrunko. Nyame peme wana menye ya. But you gave me a reason to let you stay. My life has never been the same since that day. I never felt love this special way. Is a kiss to my heart. You take my breath away. What is serious, shame I know. And it just shame I come and move. What has them that they feel good, my super.
Shed your diamond.
What people are my red one, you know. Or him, I meet his dream with him.
My
pretty shock you like Pammy. Yeah, yeah. Daddy, daddy, it make you want to spend all your money. Hey, yeah. Oh, see as my waist they go, now only you fit to make me draw. See as my waist they go, now only you fit to make me roll. Hey. Yere wa wa, 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 yere wa wa.
Welcome back from that break, viewers. We are still in conversation with the beautiful Dzifa Gray. I forgot to do something. I forgot to tell you my WhatsApp line. It's 056-0000114. I'll take it again. It's 056-0000114. That's 4 zeros. Please send in your views and your comments and your questions to the lovely Dzifa Gray.
Oh,
Dzifa,
thank you.
We are still not, I want us to enter Metro TV. We haven't okay. entered Metro yeah. TV just yet.
So Metro TV, you know, after I lost my grandmother, I was home frustrated. I was honestly frustrated. I had a lot of stress. My son wasn't here with me, you know, as a mother, with the kind of bond I had with him from when he was born, deciding to move here to take care of, you know, myself and my grandparents and also build something here before he comes. I sacrificed, you know, not being with him and left him with his father. I mean, we're great friends regardless. He recently got married and I'm so happy for him. Wow. Extremely happy for him. And so I begged him and I said, look, take care of Dylan whilst, you know, I've been with him for a while. So please, you chill with him, build that relationship as a father and mother and son.
Father and son.
Whilst I come here to also see to my family and also build my dream.
Yeah.
You know, start on a journey that will fulfill me at the end of the day. And so I came to Ghana and left him here and I was frustrated at home. And I had my, you know, when you have siblings who can frustrate, especially my brother. My brother is a troublemaker.
You know, brothers are like that.
Oh, they are, right? But, you know, they are good sometimes. They help you and all that. But do Musa, and I know the peer pressure. I think that's what it is. We all went through it. So I kind of understood. And, you know, what I try not to do is to put pressure on you, because when I was doing my own thing, my own jigger, you know, I didn't like pressure. I like it when you talk to me calmly. When you call me and say, my dear, where am I? Where am I? But when you try and hey, we'll go up, I'll throw it outside. And so I decided not to really put too much pressure. But it gets to a point where you realize that, look, but you know, my brother sometimes listen and sometimes he won't, but I'm sure we're getting somewhere now. And so I was home when Metro, I had a call from Fadi, my boss. Hello, Fadi. And he said, look, there's a program, we want you to take over. And so come around. So immediately the next day I went to the office, and do you know who recommended me? Nafisa. I mean, we did Miss Ghana together.
Ooh.
Yes. And
I didn't know you did Miss Ghana.
Yes, I did.
When?
I actually contested for Central Region.
What year?
Yeah, 2000. But I didn't win. And I think I actually decided to leave the, you know, pageant because somebody didn't want me to be part of it and stuff like that. And there was funny movement and all that. So I said,
we'll talk about that one of these days. Is it true what they do with these pageants?
No, I think that, look, it's up to you. Like I said, me, I always have my, you know, well shelf around me. So regardless what you do, you won't really get through unless I say I want to be in a relationship, I want to do a sort of thing like that. But it's a decision that an individual should make and not to be forced into. So I mean, it happens everywhere. It does. It's the extreme that sometimes can really not help the society. So basically, Nafisa, very good friend, I mean, married to Fadi's wife, you know, beautiful wife. She still looks like a model, like Tisa will Coca-Cola, like that.
Like
that. Like that. I'm
actually talking about you, you know.
Me.
You.
Hey, please, so I am not Coca to the cola, I beg you. I know what I am. Please, I beg you. But my cousins are my bread.
You don't need it, actually.
You
really don't need it.
And somebody called me, and then I went to Metro TV the next day, went to the studio, we did a trial and stuff like that. And he was like, yeah, fine. So the next Saturday I started, signed a contract, And then I started work. And this is me thinking I was home frustrated, and this is what God was planning for me, and even better things. And honestly, everything I've always wanted to do, I think that it's being portrayed on Morning Ride. The reason is because, you know, you can't sit home and execute your dreams or your you know, your passion and all that. You would have to be given a platform. And I'd like to thank Fadi and the whole team of Metro TV, most especially Nafisa. Thank you so much, sis. And so, yes, that's how I got to Metro TV. So one way or the other, it wasn't that difficult. It wasn't as if I went for looking for a job.
An audition or anything like that.
And this
that.
Is me stressing at home because I know what is in me. I know what I'm good at. I know the power God has given me, and I know my strength. And it's amazing how every individual knows, but the threats or the fears can cover it all. Every individual has got that power, and you know very well you're good at it. But
Start doubting yourself. And, can I? Will I?
Yes. You know, and what I'm good, I love doing is practicing. Like, this is me in my room, and I'll be practicing in front of the, you know, mirror. Presenting to myself. And sometimes somebody will just pop into my, you know, families who can just come into your room.
What are you doing?
Talking like, I said,
what are you doing? It's interesting you say that. Yeah. It's interesting you say that, because I had somebody here yesterday who said to me that his motto or his theme in life is, it is better to prepare than to repair. It's so interesting. I had a tutor sometime ago who said the three P's, preparation, planning, and then, I've forgotten the last P. I remember it's entirely one of these. But I think that preparation is really, really, really important. You prepare, and then you wait for the opportunity to present, present
You're
itself.
Right, Ama.
Oh, wow.
And I think
so
that
even though you had not received that opportunity, you were preparing for it.
And I watched TV. I watched the personalities like the Anita Ruskin. And I had an opportunity working with her when I came to Ghana, you know, because I wanted to do the Dzifa Great Modern Africa show here. And then we realized that this is me looking for sponsors. Hey, you'll be a person, or you'll be a person who take a bite. Come and take a ball. What's your say? And so I said, Anita, we can't find money. My brother, and the light delay. You know, when you see potential,
don't waste time.
Beat around it.
No.
And our people like doing that. And it's a very bad habit.
Yeah.
Especially the men, you know. And some women too, they find it as a threat. Especially who say nipa na baby and who ye fekakra and say bia or not so will be unique. But nipa who you're different. Or not so you're different. So why bother? And so these are some of the things that delay our progress, you know, whether you are the one giving or you are the one taking. It delays both of us, you know, our success and progress.
But Dzifa, how are you finding the show? How are you getting on with the show?
I love Morning Ride. I'm not in a good mood all day, like all the time. I mean, we're humans. I mean,
I have our bad days. Have our off days.
The bad days can be serious, and you make your mistakes sometimes. Look, it's television, it's life, and you have to be real as possible. Me dear Mark Bakakra, but hey, my dear, I am growing. That's the whole idea. That's the beauty of it to me. Sometimes I sit down and I just laugh at some mistakes. And I watch myself. Sometimes I take the video and then I watch it and I realize that, hey, this is where I went wrong. So maybe I should correct it this next time.
Live TV is not easy.
Yes. People don't know it. So when they see you on, the white is so be on Pewa Seminar TV. So I'm like, but you see, me, stuff like that are what builds me up. You might think it's breaking me, or maybe for a minute I'll be broken, but trust me, I know how to gather it together and become and turn it into
what I mean. I'll normally leave the advice for the end, but I want to ask now, what advice would you give to a young lady sitting at home now watching you and thinking, ooh, or who has always been watching and thinking, ooh, I want to be like Dzifa Gray? What would you say to such a person?
You know, I like to dive into this whole suicide thing that I've heard three girls have taken their lives.
I was going to ask about that later.
Oh, okay.
But I wanted
the
advice.
So
let's do the young ladies.
Thank you. And I give it to you, Ama. I think that, look, a lot of young youth or young ladies, the world is changing, and they want to change with it. Yeah, they're racing it. But the beauty of life is when you sit back and watch the direction people are going or things are going, and you really know that the left is mine or the right is what I where I belong to. But when you feel like, hey, I have to be here too, this person has this and I've got to get that, and this person is here and I have to be there, I am more beautiful than her, why is she there? And that is where the problem starts.
Absolutely.
It clearly shows that you don't appreciate yourself. You don't even know the life you have. You don't value it. And there is no way you are ever going to value it. And you know, life has its own consequences, and some people pay with their lives.
Yeah.
Some people die. I say to myself that some of the things I did, I'm still alive. So some of the places that I've been, I wasn't killed. I'm still alive. And so, yes, I am very fortunate, blessed to be alive. Others have a scar to show. Like the scar I talk about on television, that's a scar that I have to talk about all the time. So that I decide to talk about it because I know how terrible it is, and I want people not to repeat it or go on that, you know, lane or road. And others get away with it free. Some people get away with it free. But there is nothing like free, because you might not talk about it and nobody might know about it, but you know it yourself.
You know what you've done.
It eats you up every day of your life. And that can kill you, and that would bring you down. And as a human being, I'm sure that's what happens, that some of them want to commit suicide and all that. Because how can a guy break up with you and you kill yourself? What about them? Why? I know that, you know, it's a serious thing, because I was in, when I was young, you know, there was no mother, there was no father. So I gave my all to a guy. You know, you feel like they are the one that cares about you. People at home don't care about you, and they mess you up.
They do.
And so I understand that situation. But you see, nothing on this earth, nothing in this life, Ama, should get any girl to want to kill themselves. My dear. The beauty of life is when you wake up every day and you look in the mirror and you realize that you are still intact. There are people who are in the hospitals, accidents. It's serious, Ama. And you want to kill yourself, or you want to give up, or you want to rush in life because somebody has a Bentley. Hey, Bentley, you have a heart beating.
I think that we don't appreciate life. Just that. Life, forget everything, just life.
Yeah,
just life, just the ability to be able to wake up and be, and just be that existence.
It's true.
Human
beings are very ungrateful, it's
because
true.
It's the only way you can correct your wrongs. It's the only way you can become somebody else.
Absolutely.
It's an opportunity, isn't it?
Yeah, Ama, you see, you being in that couch or in that seat right now is a dream come true, and there are better dreams to come. You know why I say that, Ama? You know why? Because you're a sister keeper. You keep your sister. Somebody can say, because we are in the same field, okay? And this is also to the young girls, because grown-ups are doing it. Some grown-ups are doing it, I'm telling you. And these are people that young girls look up to very much. And they are doing it. They have their own threats, you know, which is very unnecessary because of where they are. But they are still on that, you know, journey where they see you and they're like, hey, when you... You know, they shake immediately and they really don't... They feel like, hey, how do I cut
that's
you
a
off?
Threat.
You cut me off. You brought me to this life, right? So, Ama, you are a sister keeper.
Oh, dear.
But young girls today... they always fight. They have a problem with somebody. You know, I'm also somebody. I'm always, who are you? You are you. That is it. You can't be any other person. So why bother, Ama? And I wish you nothing but success. Whatever dream you have, Ama, I pray that may God, the creator of all things, grant it to you.
Amen.
In all ways,
Amen.
Ama.
You too,
and if it comes through me, I'll be very happy. Dzifa. Ama, you know why I'll be very happy?
Tell me.
Because it came through me, and you will definitely remember me.
Yeah.
And that is a privilege of being somebody's helper. When you help somebody, when help comes through you, Ama, you are fulfilled.
Yeah.
It's not about money, but when you have the money, you definitely say, Dzifa besin 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 kwa nami, Dzifa minim so pe red koti minim so pe we, maminye bimano. And nami ba, you remember my son. Because I don't know how long I'm going to live on this planet. No, I don't have a clue.
Knows.
Look, my mom died at a very early age.
Yeah.
And so death is something that I'm not scared of. No. But I pray that God guide me and protect me and grant me his loving kindness, Ama.
Yeah.
And I wish that upon you. And so when help comes through me to you, Ama, I will be happy. Because I know Ama will go somewhere and talk about it. Anita helped me. I talk about Anita all the time. And I know what Anita is going through. People see Anita looking good and all that. But I know what she's going through. And she's never planned to give up. And that is the full step that I have also taken, never to give up.
It's not easy. It's not easy. And I'm happy that you are here. Let's talk about it as ladies and as women. It's not easy for a woman to climb any ladder.
No, it's not.
You know, I think society has so many expectations of you. First of all, you expect her to be beautiful. You expect her to be strong, like we're talking about before. You expect her to be soft. You expect her to be meek and mild. There are so many expectations on you as a woman trying to climb the ladder.
Yeah.
And I think that as women, we don't tell the full story.
No, I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to there's a mark on my face, and I, you know, one time I wanted to take it off when I was in London. I called my grandfather. I said, "Hey, but if you don't know your touches, then leave it. That is what makes you unique." And so I left it, and today I love it. You know, sometimes I'm with my son, we're playing, my son is touching it, he's touching my face. If he doesn't love it, he won't touch it.
No.
I think that, look, I look at women like Dr. Joyce Ayi. This is a woman who has really built a powerful platform for not just herself, but also for other women like myself. I mean, I picked the phone and I called Dr. Joyce Ayi, and she said, "Hi, Dzifa, how are you?" And I'm able to tell this one how I feel, and she tells me, "Let's pray together." She tells me, "Do it that way." This is me trying to discuss my child's school with her, and she said, "Look, this school is good. What else do you want in life?" It's not easy. Ghana, how would you contact? When you're getting a contact number from somebody and the person is, you know, somewhere high, it's a problem.
Yeah.
So when you have the privilege to even have her humble herself like this, she's one woman that honestly, I can't wait for you to have her on the show.
I will have her on
the show. I can't wait. I think really
I need her on the show.
This woman is so humble. She lay herself down for every person who is ready to learn. And even if you're not ready, she helps you go through it. She's one woman I love to celebrate, you know, this National Women's Day. Dr. Joyce Ayi. Thank you so much, mother. And so, yes, we have to be our sister's keepers.
We have to be.
And it's not easy being on this platform.
No,
mama.
It's not.
Makeup alone. Hi, Lexi. You know, the makeup alone is another thing altogether. But behind the makeup, sometimes I sleep in my makeup. But behind this makeup, what are we?
Yeah.
Are we real?
Yeah.
Are we really on television because we want to be known by people? No. We are on the... I can talk for myself, Ama.
Exactly.
I am on television because I had a story or I have experienced something that should not be experienced by humanity. But God gave me the strength to go through it. And that's the only way I can impact that on my...
On the next generation.
Doing. And I don't care what anybody sit out there to talk about. If you had it on a silver platter, what you say? But I know where I have been and how I've come out of it. So shut up and learn if you can. But if
absolutely.
Not, let those who want to learn listen.
Let them learn and do their job. Absolutely. Dzifa, when we come back, because we are going on a break now, I want us to talk about another very sensitive issue. You don't know what it is yet. I'll tell you when we go on the break.
I'm ready.
I know you are. It's Dzifa Gray. Viewers, the number to send your text to, again, is 056-0000114. It's 056-0000114. Let's know what you think about what we are doing here so far. Let me tell us. So at this point, I will take another commercial break. When I come back, there's more just with the lovely Dzifa Gray.
It's a beautiful day, I'm gonna make most of it. It's a beautiful day, a day to share with you. You'll make my world go round, yeah. It's really got me saying, nice girl.
Experience the wide range of top quality and affordable electronics, phones, tablets, home and office appliances from NASCO. NASCO, bring home happiness.
Ready? Everybody should be Rasta. Yes, Rasta Chocomot. Triumph. Oh,
Me want some more.
Oh, Grandpa. That everybody can drink Rasta.
Oh, Ben Chaleno, give me some.
Yeah, everyone loves it. Rasta Choco Malt, truly refreshing malt to drink.
Welcome back from that break, viewers. We are still on the couch. It's with me, Ama, and the ever lovely Dzifa. Dzifa, I'm enjoying you.
It's an honor.
I'm enjoying you as always.
It is an honor.
Let me read a bit of the messages and then we can just, you know, hey, I love these viewers. Well, I love my viewers. And my viewers are loving you, Dzifa. Okay, so this one says, hi, Pratt. I would love to be in touch with your guest. This is Paul Thorson from Akosombo. Dzifa, you are simply amazing. Aww. I can relate to this and I thank God for your life. This is from Sway from Abosio Kai. This one says, Ama, you made me tear up too. I love how you put yourself into your show. You'll go far. It's from Bisiwa from Cape Coast. The couch is simply amazing. Thank you, Pan African TV, for this inspiring and educative program. This is from Ima from Kaswa. Dzifa is my role model. I love her. It's from Esinam Walali from Keta. I don't ever miss your show.
Aww.
Really nice. It's Stone from Asin Fosu. This one says, you will win a lot of awards with this program. And he ends with Inshallah.
Ami.
Can I get your number, please, Ama? I have a story to share with you. This is Emanuela from Nkwanza. This one says, Pan African TV has certainly changed the face of TV in Ghana. We will continue to watch your station. This Albert from Asante Mampon. Nice. I'm really enjoying the show. You both are looking good. Tell Dzifa I admire and love her a lot. Her story made me cry. I love you, Dzifa. And when you are putting your son's pic on Instagram, when are you putting your son's picture on Instagram? He must be cute. This is Obaya from Lafayette.
I love you too, Obaya. Thank you.
Esan says, hi, Dzifa. I want to be a TV presenter. What do I do? Please advise me. Meg, Kumasi in Shiaisu. I hope I got that right.
In Shiaisu. Yeah, you know when I was Galavanti, I went to Kumasi. Is that true? I did.
Dear. This one says, thank you, Dzifa. Sorry. You are an inspiration to the youth. You go, girl. Mavis Kumasi. This one says, your program is the most watched now in the whole of Bronga Hafu region. You and Kwame are the best and the sky is the limit.
Hey,
God bless you all. Sorry. I'm not sure people know about that angle.
Hey, please, I'm telling you.
This one says, Alhaji Usman in Tamale, watching you live. The couch is the best. This one says, you have just made my evening. Such beautiful souls. Ama, I see you as Africa's Oprah. Hey.
Oh, yes, I believe that. I do.
Chukwu Emeka from Nigeria. This one says, watching you in Nigeria, your station is doing really well. Congrats. From Chidemma from Lekki.
Oh, wow.
This one says, sending you love from Liberia. Wow.
Wow.
Good show. We love it.
Thank you.
You are good. Ewusi from Takrade. This one says, thank God for your show. It's the best show now. Congrats to you, Ama. Please, can I get your first number? Helen from Dansoman Last Stop.
This one says, you ladies are gorgeous. Beautiful set you have. The couch all the way. Benedict from Kitaho. This one says, Dzifa, are you married? I need to know. Don't dodge Philemon in his leg.
I am single.
She's single. But you have to come for vetting. You know, I have to vet. I have to vet him. This one says, hello, Ama. I want to tell Dzifa that she should have been a lecturer. She's very marvelous. Wow. I like her very much. From Izidin Tamale. Please tell Dzifa I like how she speaks and that I want her number. She got Ama getting so emotional. Love you all. You all are looking good. This one is from Alajo. Okay. Hello, Immaculate Georgina Agri is my name. Aww. I really love this show. I love Dzifa. You be too much. Love you both. Okay. I really love your programs. My greetings goes to Madam Regina Owusu and Mame Anan at Aputwaja Oyoko. Please, I hope I got it. This one is from Kweku Dako at Tepa. I'm really enjoying the show. In fact, Dzifa is very beautiful. Yes, she is. I want to hear you speaking Ewe. From Van Elom, Sunyani Technical University.
Oh.
This one says, I always cry when I listen to her. I wish I can speak with her one day.
Wow.
This one says, all the time, God is really good, Sister Ama. God richly bless you. Please tell Sister Dzifa, I ask God blessings for her.
Amen.
This is from Aram Sukura.
Amen.
This one says, please, I'm loving your program. From Ernest Kofi in Koforidia. Thank you all so much. Wow. Thank you all so much. Please keep the views and comments coming in.
Thank you.
Somebody wants your number.
Oh, you know what? I don't hesitate giving my numbers, you know, out. The reason is because you don't know what it is. And I've had this encounter with a lady where I would have regretted. I think God would have punished me one way or the other. That's how I feel. I mean, it's different how you feel when you get to know the real deal, right? And I'm happy. It's another story to share, and I'd love to have her on your show. This woman was about to go, and then I went in, and it was nothing. It was just something petty, you know, when it's just somebody to just hug you and tell you you'll be fine. And so that's how I think that it's very important for women or the young girls should have people around to encourage
to be able
them.
To even talk to
them. That's all. The boys, they just jijit them and jijit their body and mess them up and mess just leave them.
Yeah. Dzifa, you are the only person I can ask this.
Please, you.
You know this thing going on now where they say that celebrity ladies can't get married. And, you know, there's the society's expectation. At a certain age, you should be married and all of that. And it's come up strongly when we've had somebody in this country actually name names and say that these ladies are not going to get married ever. And Dzifa, you are in the industry. You know, you are a presenter. Metro TV, Morning Ride.
Oh, thank you, Ama.
And Dzifa, you are single and married. How does that make you feel?
You know what? I don't feel focal. Hey, I do not. Well, first of all, let me applaud you. Because why are you? Why is your wedding? Why your engagement? Your show, whether he's being nice. Well, it's Kwame.
Bad.
It is the Kwame you see on television on this program every morning. That is her husband. Is he ever? And
who asked you for?
But you see, honestly, Ama, it's because you decided to and you were prepared to do that. Okay, and Kwame, you're ready to go through it with him and he's ready to stand by you. But if I'm not ready, you cannot force me.
No.
Because minim niyama komu. I know what I've been through. I am a single parent. And there is no way that I'm going to get involved with any other man. And I know myself, you know, when you are and you know where I get involved. That is my soft spot. It's love. My own thing is love. When I'm in love, I will show him coming muscle. Sure, he is important. But I would have to know how to balance it. And I have been through it not once, not twice, not three times. So you cannot sit elsewhere and say, when you over 30 or Kodi 40 on warrior, what's that your, how is that your business? That cannot be your business. You should know why. Nipa ninko mu. People sit on television and say, I mean, we on ya worry ye on the nam nam mem and ya memas only Ama, if I tell you what I ask my PA or my producer Kojo, ask him or Becatro or share me so see, hey, and uncle for him, sir, what do you say? And Miss Asawa be who? And you, Ama, I told the beer, one show who ye are, and who trained you over quack or worry. When you know very well that if I take 1, 2, 3 steps, and I'll be well prepared before a man comes my way.
Yeah.
And when that man comes, so be home soon for swore, or about the baby baby can now to me mouse up high. Now they are normal. Now don't stop high, Bebasa. First of all, me or cargo, me bano, or your cargo, mommy. What else? Oh, bano, your cargo. If
you're not gorgeous.
Hey, now my son is humble, but hey, if you're not, if you and they say, "Well, baby, pound to mash and the papa, because I know affordable." What I say, "Now, baby, we Ghana, Africa, and so we need move fine." But if baby, we say, "Well, college school, I walk." I want to put my son in a good school. I know Ghana is really hard now.
Things yeah, are
really
hard. Tough.
And to pay to get your child a good education, you have to at least get a teacher at home. Ube chia, ube ko good school. School on him say, "Well, hands on me, yeah, dear kaka." If you are now baby, na fees no hunt chia. Ne papa ne waso chia, but emre Daniel, emre Daniel. What else here? And then you cannot handle it, and then it will become a problem. Hey, now matter to the only sick and neighbor, then you, you boy, is a lie. Or be catch yourself, oh, a dog be brace, is a lie. Oh boy, I used to say that, or dog a crassy caca, me boy, me boy, sika wa hua, eh, and now say, Juma, a hondin wa hua, me boy, me and the kind, me say, me boy, oh, me boy, Dzifa, I said it. I used to say it to my friend, Laisa. Hi, Laisa, my very good friend, Tessa and Laisa. Me see. Tessa, Laisa, oh, your doctor can see Kaka, come to know who's a me, I'll help. Mini, tell me, help me, who's this here. So it's not by force that, you know, Obedu HB, and it's our culture because it was so
warm. Everybody expects
now, Yen Yama. Now, me, I'm your back with the and I mean, I know how sharp I am. What did I say? Mini, sharp. It's in me, come, who's this here, and then me, warrior. Oh, mommy, 1 week, me, Bama. Oh, we won't say, be an amicata bottle. What did I say? Mini, me, capacity, mini, my holding. Now, hey, you know, I don't have to rush into it.
Mm-mm.
But don't sit back and talk about people no, like that. Maybe you should find one way or the other to get to know whether there's a problem or not. But I think that a lot of the industry alone is another thing. You see, they're exposed to many things. And so I'm going to this industry. Go for nimnyamao. And then Uber will be why you can tante said they were Kwame put Kwame is good. Oh Kwame dear there be chef. Kwame is good. Not perfect. We the better be any perfect. But Kwame is good. Who are perfect ma. But any bright me also me checking my what you say. But hey, go for the say shape no mu chabro for no no num car ni mu no mu missy can 7 year chani 7 year one of them almost he when you need a 6 pack. It be a 1 pack in the crown, eh, you know. What I be a 1 pack no. No, I'm being honest with you. I be a 1 pack no. Be a obe ban obe ye diet ni ye. And I'm a boy.
It's true.
And not 1 money. I thought I know no ma money. Jai on sushi no. Whenever lime kaka womb. Na pack 1 pack ne kofom kaka 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 kaka. Be 1 winya 8. Na 6 for no number. They don't have focal. Focal. I'm on this shit. And so I'm on because I'm on TV so. And I say be a what I say. Anya muni na o papa womu.
Well.
Nankanka to two quiet the end and now when you go say, "Emi your gun and Bishia we a good combination." Wow, oh bet hey, ube be fear now Ghana must go crown cra. So the thing is it's not really
It's not about that.
I think that they just are careful.
It's not about that.
And they've been through relationship because everybody knows who they want to end up with. You wanted to end up with Kwame and you're with Kwame because Kwame made that effort. But there's this case where women are making effort, men are making effort, and they are not getting anywhere. And so what's the point? Why just relax? And I think that's what I've done. And it's amazing how there's somebody who really likes me. I see it. I feel it. I feel it. I feel it. But you know, I still have to take my time. And so, Ama, if I come to you and I tell you, Ama, I'm getting married next year or next week or tomorrow, you will know that, oh, Dzifa, wait here.
I will know
oh,
that. Yeah,
Papa, because Nipane was so humidam, no. Maybe what I'm... Oh, be our dam. I'm a, that will be.
Absolutely.
Yeah, we all do.
Absolutely.
We have that other side, and it's very important for a man to know it because I know any man will we need the to come back. We come back with this kabefi. What do you say? Ejuma, we need uni kaka unti minye.
No, you have to be.
Hey, very important.
You have to
you
be.
See, so I think that it's they have to stop that. It's really unnecessary.
It's unnecessary.
It is unnecessary. Yes.
It's unnecessary. It somebody wanted to see a picture of your son.
Yeah.
Dzifa, let's do something better for you.
I know. Give them an exclusive.
Let's do something.
Yes.
So, Dzifa's adorable son
gorgeous. You see for yourself in a minute. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous man is in the studio. And because viewers are asking to see him,
yeah,
my sister has been gracious enough,
yeah,
to let the son,
yeah,
come join us on the
set. He came back 3 days ago. Hi, Dylan.
Thank you very much, Dylan. Thank you so much, honey. Dylan, please sit. Thank you. Oh, wow. Look at him.
You're right. High five.
Dzifa, you must be proud.
Thank you, Dylan, for the water. I am extremely proud. I am.
Dylan, hi. How are you finding Ghana so far?
Good.
Just good? Or brilliant? Look at him. Wow. How is mommy? Tell me about mommy.
She's good.
She's good, isn't she? She's very good. And you know she's happy to have you here, right? And you're happy to see her. Dzifa, look at him.
Yes. And I tell you that when I was pregnant with my son, I had few words that I wasn't pleasant from, you know, wherever it's coming from. You know, he's here, so we have to be nice, yes? And so, yes, that hey me peba me pebema one mommy bema, you know, they have a way of saying it. Ama, don't cry again, they are bre. Auntie Ama has been crying the whole time, you know that, Dylan. And so come closer, Dylan.
I will be good.
Oh, and so mommy bema, so when I was pregnant, I would pray for, hey God, please give me a beautiful boy, God, give me a beautiful boy. And when I saw my, when I had a C-section, because you know it was really, I was big, and Dylan, you see him, he's only 8, and look at how big and tall he is. You know, his dad is really tall, and so you know, when they brought Dylan out of my belly, this is the doctor saying your son is beautiful, and I, you know, epidural, so definitely I couldn't really see, but I felt so relaxed. And so when I saw him, they gave him to me, and look at me, and immediately I was like, oh my God, I have a son like this. And so I have been grateful for, and this boy is incredible. I love you.
Look at him.
I love my son.
Look at him. Of course, see, my phone won't stop buzzing. Let me try and read a few of the messages that have come in so far. Dzifa, you are okay. So this one says, hey Dzifa, you are pretty, papa.
Oh, thank
this
you.
One says, please tell sister Dzifa to my godmother, I really meant it, I love her so much.
Thank you.
This one says, Dzifa is sweet, pa. I want to marry her. Onapo. Sly papa in Mampon Ekuyapem. This one says, I love your show. 2 thumbs up to you. Mercy in Bunsukumasi. This one says, hello girls, impossible is nothing. From Alhaj Yakubu Abdallah Ofinsu Ashanti. This one says, Ama, your show is so great. Thank God for your program. You made me weep in my office in Osu. It's from Maybell Koran. This one says, hello Ama, you look more beautiful and I like you so much. I watch Pan African TV because of you.
Oh, stay blessed. Nice. Keep
texting
watching
from Keta. My sister says, keep watching. This one says, experience, they say, is the best teacher. Dzifa, you get experience, pa. Fila. And Misty J in Koforidua, sorry. This one says, all that she's saying is true, but my question is, don't sugar daddies disturb you? And this is from Frank Opon in Kwadaso Estate. This one says, Ama, you are so intelligent. And Dzifa too, God bless you all. Tinkwan in Ashtown, Kumasi. This one says, oh, Sister Ama, tell Auntie Dzifa that she is killing me slowly with her wares. Aww. Amazing. From Immaculate Agri. This one says,
oh,
wow.
The second one from
yes,
her.
The second one. This one says, wow, your son is so cute, Dzifa. I want to give him to my daughter. Me late, please, I beg you. I have already registered Dzifa's son, please. This is a no-go area. I love you. Send, keep sending your views in, but registered. This one says, sweet boy. This
Thank
is,
you.
I really love your show. My greetings goes to Kwabena Apache at... Okay, Kofi Mark. Sir Macho Atepe. I'm sure they know exactly what she means. Forgive me that I can't
really
mention all that you are saying. Oh, this one says, thanks, Ama, for making my wish come through. Her son is so cute.
Obaya from La Paz, the one who wanted to see the picture.
Yes. Oh, yeah. Yes. Obaya, yes. For you.
Yes. Yes.
So, all the viewers.
Dzifa, how are you going to combine this? You're not a full-time mother. Yeah. How are you going to combine? Because I know you're busy.
Yes. No, I am. But the truth is that, Ama, this is the reason why I'm busy. This boy is the reason why, and many more to come with a good man who has some good cash.
Good cash.
Oh, no, it definitely has to be. You know, and I think that I have. It's all about balance, because when you know, God knows what your priority is. And so he knows why Dylan is around at this time. Because, you know, the time for school is not really good, but he's here. And honestly, for the past 2 days, my producer and I has just been, Dylan has been running, just trying to get a good school for him. We went to about 4 schools and we landed, in a day. And honestly, God is good. And so he's going to take a test and we'll get him.
He will pass.
Oh, of course he is. So Dylan will be fine. And you see, this boy is... Dylan, tell them about yourself.
Tell us, Dylan.
Dylan is amazing. Dylan, he's a bit shy, but when he's off camera, he's another thing altogether.
And he's handling it so beautifully. Oh, he's on TV, and look at him. He's so composed and relaxed.
And look, I think that this boy will grow up and make Ghana proud, and his life and myself proud, because I know that, look, he's in touch with some great people in this country. Yourself as an auntie, Kwame as an uncle, and look, God, he knows God, and he tells me to my face when I'm wrong. Ask my producer.
What else can you ask?
No,
for?
My son is blunt like that.
What else can you ask for?
Sometimes I feel it's too much, but
no.
And but he tells the truth, yeah. And it's one of the things I like about him, being honest in life.
Yeah.
You know, it really takes you a long way.
Yeah.
So I'm balancing, definitely. But look, my son is very helpful. He's a producer for Prime Zone, the show that I'm producing. I'm the executive producer for Prime Zone. It's a youth show. It's gonna be.
I was gonna ask you what's next.
Yes. Yes. Hey,
you're such a presenter. It's like before I think you have.
There's a lot of things coming up.
tell me about some of them.
Look, we have plans for Pan African.
Definitely.
We have content for Pan African.
Definitely.
Amazing ones. Mm. And you know, it's been authorized by, you know, the head.
Yes.
Yourself, yes. And Kwame, yes, to produce, yes, something, yes, great. And but currently Dylan is the producer for Prime Zone. The reason I made my son the producer for Prime Zone is because I want him to know the line of work that I'm in. And he's very creative because he wants to host a kid show in Ghana. And I think he'll be great at it with some other kids, you know. And so he is in it to make sure that he builds, you know, a career for himself. Even after school, you know, he doesn't really want to get into the corporate world. He knows that the creativity is one that you can make good money out of and also inspire people in the world. So, Dylan, you are the producer for Prime Zone, right?
Yes. Yeah, he is. Okay, this one says, I want to hear him talk.
Dylan, please.
And it's from Mavis in Sucre.
Yeah. Say hi to Mavis.
Hi.
Hi, Mavis.
Yes.
Okay, this one says,
I want you to ask Dylan about his father. Dylan, let's talk about your dad a bit, because he's been great, right? And what are some of the things that you guys do that really... You miss him already. What are some of the things you do? Go on.
Just chill.
Yeah.
And what?
And he helps me do stuff.
Like what?
Like, if I'm stuck playing a game, and then he comes to me and helps.
No, this boy is amazing.
Adorable.
He is.
He's adorable. This one says, oh, what a beautiful son you have.
Thank you.
This one says, we are watching you from Brekum. And we want to tell Dzifa we love her and her son.
This one says,
I want to marry you, Dzifa.
Oh,
are you married?
I'm not.
She's not. Please, she's not. This one says, hello, Ama. I rushed from work just to watch you. Though I'm late, I'm enjoying the program. Dzifa is a true African lady. It's Henry from Tamale.
Thank you.
See, guys, all of you sending in these messages, the person to vet you is me.
Tax collector. Hey, tax in the energy. Ama will collect, Papa, every week.
So please see me.
You see, the question that came up, you know, there was a question about... whether sugar daddies were...
Yes, hey, yeah, somebody wanted to know
about
that.
They
will.
And it's not only sugar daddies. What do you call sugar daddies?
The my older ones. Yeah, the very older. Old ones with lots of money. With lots experience. And lots of money.
Okay, my son is here. And Dylan, I love my son so much.
Mm.
Look, regardless what you do in life, you have everybody come up to you.
Mm.
The devil will come. The angels will come. The good friends will pretend. I mean, they are the devil. They are. Those ones are killers.
Mm.
And honestly, everybody will come. But sometimes, you know, you might meet somebody. I have been in a relationship where, you know, the person, you know, was married or is married. Mm. It's in the past, okay?
Mm.
And honestly, you realize that, look, it's not really a pleasant thing at the end of the day. And I'm sure that's what she calls sugar daddy. But you realize that, I realize that I have so much love in me that I cannot share it with somebody
else. No.
I have been in a relationship where the person didn't tell me he, you know, he's married. And then I got to know myself because I got the address of the house and I went there and the person was there. So I got there and said, the woman came out. This is me saying, hi, how are you? Please, is he in? And then he said, yes. I said, oh, I know you. I've told him to bring you because, you know, you can marry. He can marry. He's a Muslim. So he can marry more than one. I said, you know about me? He said, yes. Oh, my catch is on my own breath. You know, you're into nothing. One into nothing. You know? And then he came out. He said, But you see, that's why I say that some people get away with things and others have a scar for it.
Mm.
I've gotten away with some of them and I have a scar, but nothing is for free.
Mm-mm.
So in that case, so I've been through it all.
Mm.
It's here. Mm. So sugar daddies, they will come. Media, honestly, if somebody comes into your life, look, this is a fact, and I'm saying it, everybody in the studio, please listen on. You see, Ama, Kwame is married to you.
Mm.
If Kwame misbehave, call me.
I will.
Thank you. But you
ladies, I will.
Out there, ladies out there, if you find somebody who you know very well that can be of great help to you, and you know that wechino en kafoma ma unaisi koko pebuti biche yesi kanye wesa ye buti bi so ya for the police for the why worry brand there yeni enu na abe pe sakope anase obe kwa kope eyi mini gana se dey were leather wele nu yenje di ne fa nye leather shoe ankasa what you say na shebi so wechino en kampa no so na form ne di ajina ho ni pare so ope ope me okay me so me pe se o. But me person I go away. Wow, me when I meet somebody, are you married? I mean that was then, but now I don't even have time.
No.
And told me, Sammy, are you married? After that incident, are you married? Yes, please go your way. I'm not interested.
Mm-hmm.
If you are not married, I look at you pa and no. I just get over me breh. Yeah, name say Jumebi. What you say?
You're too busy.
Apart from that, no, I think about the fact that hey, I think I'll be you know when they start calling, hello, how are you? What are you doing? Hey, what am I doing? Me yeah, Juma. And I've my gonna media me how far. What in Yamasa say? Hey, and I'll be it's support, it is not mommy's support. You like somebody, I'm a me pewasem, oh femi Dzifa, me yeah we be boy me studio. Meba, because me pewasem, what's the whoop me? Upemi is a different thing altogether. So you are concerned about everything I do.
Mm.
So in your own little way you have, that doesn't mean come and give me 50 Ghana cedis.
Mm-mm.
You understand what I mean?
Mm.
No.
I get
some
it.
Some people are laughing in the studio because I think they get 50 Ghana cedis.
Oh, they get more than that.
So come and give me that. But at least sit me down and tell me, okay, this is what you're in. I'm interested and I want to see how.
Every field.
So yes, I mean, sugar daddies will come, but no, be smart, okay?
Let me read a few of the messages that are still coming in. This one says, I admire you both. Very adorable San Dzifa from Gladys. This one says, hello, good evening. My name is Atongo from Duayam in Kwanta. I want to be a father to the American boy. He's not American, he's British. I'm enjoying your show. This one says, hello, Ama. I like your son. I wish he were my son, but he's the first son. I want to marry him. Hey,
from another beautiful one soon.
Aduma Gladys in Santasi. Amen, Dzifa.
Amen.
Then says, hi, Ama. Tell Sister Dzifa I want her as my big sister. So where will I find her? Please, I need her number. And I would like the son to be my kid brother.
No.
This is Seiram from Koforidia. This one says, Dzifa is very beautiful.
Thank you.
Tell Sister Dzifa I love and share her thoughts on being single. So much love from Jandel inside Akache. This one says, lovely son, and Ama, you look good. This one says, hi, I really admire the boy. Ama and Dzifa, you are too much. DJ Toronto from Pink FM, Kaswa.
Thank you.
This one says, good evening. I really like Dzifa and son. Hi, my name is Steven from Takwa. I'm really enjoying the show. I just want to know the name of the boy. He looks so big and so sweet. This one says, the couch, oh, the couch. All the way. You guys are looking splendid and sweet. I really love the show, and I'm really learning a lot tonight. Ama, please tell Dzifa that I really love her so much, and I would love to get her number. You guys are blessed by God Almighty. Much love to you guys.
Amen.
Why? Sarah Premper from Labadi. This one says, good evening. I really like Dzifa and son, and I want to marry the son from Tema. Dzifa and Ama, you are so special. My greetings goes to my dear one, Madam Regina Owusu-Tepa Maban from Sir Evans. This one says, Auntie Ama, please tell Auntie Dzifa and her son that I love them so much.
Thank you.
And can I have her number? This one says, hi, I only watch Pan-African TV because of the couch. Since I became interested, since you interviewed Becca, I love Dzifa.
Oh, that was another exclusive.
Yeah. I love Dzifa and the way she talks. I love you also, Ama. I want to know where Dzifa's son's father is. Keep it up, Ama. This one says, hi, Dzifa, you look gorgeous. Is your son half caste? I love him. I'm proud of you. This one says, I love this show. Keep it up, Ama. I really want to see your husband's picture. This one says, hi, I'm dying watching Dzifa, and I think I'm in love with her already. Kindly let me have her number, or give her mine. It's from Pabs from Tadi. This one says, I really like the show. It's so interesting. You are too much, Dzifa. I love you bunch. You ladies look so gorgeous. It's from Gloria from Tamale. This is Mina. Dzifa, you and your son look so cute. This one says, cute dimple. I'm out. Oh, thank you.
Yeah, I've always
loved that. And this, hi, Dzifa, you look gorgeous. Is your son half caste? Second time. It's from Ima Odina Kwadaso. The one before the Kwadaso work, I couldn't pronounce. This one says, please, good evening. Please tell the woman I love her from Kumasi. Dorothy and I need her number. Thanks. Who is Dorothy? Hello, I love Dzifa so much.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Frida from Okemada. I love your talk and the advice. This one says, good evening. Oh, where did that go?
Oh, Ama, you are so into this thing. Eh?
Yes, the text messages, you know, oh God.
Vanished.
Okay. Good evening, Miss Host. Please let me know where you did the hairdo.
Oh.
And in order for me to let my wife go there.
Oh, that's hey, that's not happening.
And do same. This that's is from nice. Bawa Amenten in Kwanta. Hello, I like Dzifa so much.
Oh,
I haven't seen anyone as real as Dzifa. Well, Dzifa is very real. God bless you both. This one says, hi, my name is Sandra from Kwabena, and I'm so loving the show, and I love Dzifa so much. Please tell Auntie Dzifa that I love her very much. I'm Joseph from Takwa. Hello, this is the dry fisherman from Dansoman.
Dry.
Please tell Dzifa the boy is so fine. Do you know a dry fisherman?
I don't
fisherman?
Know. I wish. Dry. What do you mean by dry fisherman?
I have no idea.
Men are not bold. Yeah.
I love your boy. He is so cute. From Jane Prestia. This one says, if you meet someone and he's a sugar daddy and wants you to give birth with him, what should you do? This one says, hello. Oh, it's the same dry fisherman again. Hi, my name is Sandra from Kwabena. Okay, I've read this one. This one says, I'm happy being single, and I love the show. I'm really enjoying the show. From Nana Kwame Afari from Kuforidia. This one says, I love your show, Ama. I love you, Dzifa. It's from Mabel from UGC Kumasi. This one says, please tell Sister Dzifa, I love her so much. Can she be my godmother?
Aww.
This one says, Ama, good evening. Please, Ghanaian girls, kindly leave the young man alone. Please allow our future president to grow. Don't pollute him with so I love. Shine your eyes. This one is on Evans in Kumasi. Evans, you're funny.
Amen.
This one says, Auntie Dzifa is looking beautiful, and she has a wonderful son.
Thank you.
Please, I love Auntie Dzifa. And please, what's the solution for this problem? And how can we maintain our backs? You know, when you spoke about the backs.
You can.
This is hi, good evening. Tell Dzifa I love her. I'm Pearl from Upper East. Hi, you look gorgeous, Dzifa. In fact, I like your son to be my friend. Aww. I'm Lizzie from Accra. Hi, I'm Frida from Odan. I really love the woman so much. And the way she's dressed. Can I get her number?
Thank you.
This one says, hi. Oh Lord. Okay. Hello, Sister Dzifa. I love you so much. Please, I want to speak with you. I just want to hear your voice. Please. Aww. This one says, Dzifa, you are too much. I love your confidence. Before you go, please give me a freestyle. More of them. From Hamdi Atakwa. Good evening. And how is everyone? Your program is nice. And Ama, you are looking blessed.
Very.
Emmanuel from Halfasin. Hi, Ama. I really love your program. You and Dzifa are looking very awesome. I'm already in love with Dzifa, and I want her as my godmother. This is from Rosemary from CAF University. Mm. I love the show. Keep it up, Ama. I really want to see your husband's picture. Please, when will the show come on again? Next week, Friday. This one says, hi, I'm Ekuya Penyin Takrade. I really love your show. Please, I need your number, Dzifa. I salute you. Hi, I'm Samuel from Nalerigu. Please, Ama, I like your show so much. Tell Dzifa that I love her son. Hi, I have never watched your show. Today is my first, but I love your show. I love Dzifa. This from Bella from Aflao. Ama, I just love your show. You are too much. Keep it up. From Chumesi Kumase. Priscilla from Teshi. Love the woman so much and her kid. Nuruddin Taslima is my name. Please tell Dzifa to go back to her son's dad. I love her. Then says, hi, I'm Ibrahim. I really love your show, Ama. Please kindly tell Sister Dzifa she's so beautiful and her son is also so cute. She's my role model. I love her bunch. God bless her so much. Hi, good evening. Tell Dzifa I love her. I'm Pearl from Upper East. Please, can I get Auntie Jifa's number? I'm Patience from Upper West. Dzifa is very beautiful. Tell my sister to take good care of her son. Okay, I think I've done well.
Ama, we had you. Make a message. Now I'm intimate with you.
I think I'm done. I like to keep the viewers happy.
Ama, I give it to you.
I like to keep the viewers happy.
It's the truth. You know, I hardly read messages so much. This isn't true.
But everybody is loving him.
But this boy is not half caste. For where? Please, my son is not half caste. This one's Zomi. Can't you see Zomi? This is Zomi pure. Ananibwa. Ah! This is Zomi. Dylan is just, you know. Ewen, number 9 Moja OCDN. You know that sentiment like number 9 here. But this is pure Zomi, okay? Fine Zomi from my hometown. Fine one. Yeah, say thank you.
So cute. Dzifa, the ladies want advice. They want you to tell them, you know, about everything you've said. All the things that came in.
Yeah.
They just want
advice. It's just, look, Ama, I cannot tell your story for you can only tell your story appropriately, and in the real of it would have to pop out from your own mouth or your heart, okay? And if you can't even talk, we mukra na obeti mi atro what you say na sign language, you know? Yeah, when I beti mi I say bia oto amenim ama he o e bia oto amenim wa meto amenim what you say mimi de ni minim de we say no. Everybody can, you know, we can only share our own stories, and don't allow people to tell your story differently. Some people think they know you. You know when your friends, I know you for a long time, and then maybe a sunai fi amehuye we hin kaka onim se okokan wa sema okan mati so onim mi pa so onim.
No.
You do not know.
No.
They don't know you.
No.
You know yourself, and you know why certain things happen. Yes, some of them might be wrong, but you know why it happened. Are you ready to correct it? It's a decision you have to make. Nobody can tell you to do that. What else here? And you know, don't let people describe you for you to change. What in your say? One kasa unim sa niyawe nenye. Me edu baby am who say mommy baby awokon ube wo. And so everything, and my grandparents were really humble. My grandfather is one patient person. Hey, patient human being. Papa no aboteo. Share. Ono na mi auntie ska say, hey, na we dey do sorry, I was just short skirt sa. What to be a man? Do you understand what I mean, Ama?
Yeah.
You're always complaining she likes mini skirts and stuff. But have you given her any long skirts to wear?
Exactly.
No, you haven't. So why complain? Bring the long skirts or the long dresses. If I do not wear it, that's when you have the right to talk. But they just talk because they think, hey, they have the mouth. The worst is those who can make noise like I do. You know, when they see you, oh, jari cry, ko kasem, oh, piagin from akwa si bobwe near to onyo, Mr. Tua, oh, brave jai. And I'm a boy, but I do baby. Nyankuponka say, hey, me bay. And Ama, this is me. I'm here on television talking about it. Some people are not bold enough to do that.
Yeah,
but I do not really mind. Because the woman that will meet my child in the future, you know, should know that, hey, mommy, where your cow? Mami ko hunye miye. I mean, I would love my son's, you know, he's still young. You're young.
He's very young. He had him smile.
He made him smile.
You made him smile.
You know, but you see, he would definitely want to when he grows. And yeah. And I'm not going to force him like people are talking about women who are at a certain age who should get married and all that. But yes, I mean, it will have to be somebody who knows that, hey, my mother-in-law is funny. She's shaggy. She's this. She's that.
She's
she's like that. But
shaggy.
I love my mother-in-law. I want to be that kind of woman.
Yeah.
Do you understand what I mean? I want to be that kind of mother-in-law and stuff like that. So, girls, you rock and be positive and
be
don't
positive
let people change your
be positive
your
everybody wants your number everybody wants your
number. There is
number,
a number you can give out, I'm sure.
Okay.
No, there's a number you can give out.
Okay, give us a number.
Okay,
we can give
so
out.
I don't know whether my producer will allow me to do that, but okay, so no, but you see, you don't know who wants to call, who wants to say something that, you know, is very important. So maybe on 0202416658, that number would be.
Can you please repeat it?
0202416658.
Oh, if I don't do
okay,
this.
0202416658.
6658.
Yes.
CVS.
I said,
please call her.
No. Send me a message on WhatsApp.
Okay.
And I'll definitely reply you. I mean, I call sometimes. I'm yes. Yes. I think message and I'll definitely reply one way or the other. Yes.
Okay.
But please, so don't call me and say, you find that? And I like, please. You know, if you're a guy, me and Toasty me is his house. So it's going to be a problem. But hey, people are starting.
People are already calling. Oh my goodness. Okay. So I'm Godfred from Techiman. You are pretty as your boy. But my question is, based on what you are saying, please, how can a man approach a lady? It's like you are drawing we the guys away from my lady. So I need your number, sister Dzifa from Aduma Gladys. In fact, Dzifa has just revealed the top secret, and I understand the reason why Kwame is always on fire. I'm a salute to Evans from Kumasi. Dzifa, you look so beautiful. Akosia from Sinyane. Hi, I'm Maslin from Ashoman Estate. I like Dzifa, she's so beautiful, and
thank
her
you.
Son. Hi, I'm Fafa from Satellite. I just want to tell Ghanaians to leave that boy alone. Hi, Auntie Dzifa. Does it mean you don't enjoy sex anymore?
Oh, that's a good one. That's a very good one. No, this is a very good one. It is a good one, Emma. Look, I am a real woman. You don't want to know. I think that... I am, Emma. Look at... Where did you marry Star? No. Yes. So I'm a real woman, and that is why I give my all when I'm in a relationship. It is me and my all. It's part of it. Sex is part of when.
Yeah.
Understand what I mean.
Please, can I? Can I? Hi, I'm Ruth from Nyanyono. Really enjoying the show. From Tony Sunyane, Dzifa is a bold woman. God bless her and a handsome son. Priscilla from Teshi. I love the woman so much and her kid. Please send her my number from Teshi. I like your makeup. Hello. God bless you guys. Tell her my family loves her. Ama, you are doing great. From Tony Sunyane, Dzifa is a bold woman. I like the way she flows, and I pray her story inspires many.
Amen.
Go high, Dzifa and son.
Amen.
Ama, I like your show. Keep it up. From Nali Rigu. Hi, Madam Host. I'm in Giza from Isiama. When will you invite me and my beautiful daughter? This is my sister Dzifa. You do all beautiful queen from Shalom Z number 9 all the way. This one says, hi, please ask Dzifa whether she can visit us at the north. This is from Yao Bolga.
Yeah.
Hi, this is Joshua from Navrongo. Please, the Ghanaian girl shouldn't spoil the boy.
I know. I'm trying.
I'm Eliken from Bolga. Tell her I want her as my big sister. Tell her I need her contact. Hey, this is Etonam from Akache. Auntie Dzifa, I'm proud of you. Keep being real. Hi, sister. Tell sister Dzifa, I love her confidence. She has a lovely son, and I love your program. From Madra from Kumasi. Ama, today is my first time watching this program too. I wish Sister Dzifa will be the one coming on the show every day. Please tell her to give us the number before the program ends. Please. And I equal to you for reading your messages. This is Seriam again. I love you, Auntie Dzifa. I'll bet at Takrade. I'm Israel from Madenta. I really like the show. And Auntie Dzifa, you look so beautiful and
thank
cute.
You.
God richly bless you. for the advice. I love that sweet boy. He's so adorable. Auntie Dzifa, you do all. I'm loving the show from Rabbi Bolga. Hi, Dzifa. This is Latifa from Wa. I love you. Hello, Ajua from the Dump City. Love your show. I don't miss it. Please, am I the last to ask for Jifa's number? I'm waiting. I'ma tell the guy at the studio that I need him as my son-in-law. He is too handsome and too cute. This is Romy inside the choir, Ashanti. Hey, Ama, tell Sister Dzifa she is so cute and her son is so cute too. Wish I was so young. He would have been my boyfriend. Hey. Little Nanesi from Mataheko. Nanesi, you don't sound so little. This one says, hi. Frida, again, I wish you were my elder sister from Oda. Wow. Dzifa, I have...
No, but you see, wait, hold on. That last message you just read, it's a serious one. You know what, Ama, when somebody says, I wish you were my elder sister, you want to find out that what is it, why? Because I sometimes feel like, you know, I wish I had a bigger sister or brother because I'm the first child. And the pressure being a first child, you know, when there's no property or anything left for you. You know that thing? A sunny day to me, see at any time. But you see, when stuff, you know, preparation, that's a preparation I want to make sure that I put in place for my children, God willing. And so, you see, when people, messages like that touches me, and I'm very inquisitive and I want to find out why. Because for all you know, there's something that is bothering, there's something that, you know, needs to be heard, needs to be solved. You know, it's not all about money, but sometimes we all need that companionship. This girl might really need a sister. And yes, I mean, send me messages on Facebook and Instagram. My inbox is fine. And I know that, look, a lot of people are not genuine. You have people who, they are scams and all that. But look, it's God that guides human beings. And I try to be very vigilant, stuff like that. I mean, so just be honest.
Be honest. Viewers, so Dzifa says you can send her messages on her Facebook and on Instagram. Yeah. Are you on Twitter?
I am on Twitter.
And on Twitter. All the social media platforms. What's your full name on Facebook?
It's Dzifa Abekwe Gray.
Dzifa Abekwe
Gray. And then Instagram is Dzifa Gray.
Instagram is Dzifa Gray.
And
Twitter
is Dzifa Gray.
Dzifa Gray. So please, send her all the messages. I see all the messages, but you know I can't read them all. We don't have 6 hours.
Hey, but why are you?
I can't read them all.
You've done incredibly
but I'm
well.
Happy. I'm happy that incredibly you send the messages
well.
In.
Yes.
I'm happy that you are watching. Please keep, you know, sending in your feedback, the comments and all of that. We'll do our best to you. Dzifa, I've enjoyed you. And you have to come back.
Ama, you know,
you have to come back.
There are more great things to come, God willing.
Yes, there. Obviously. I mean, the two of us did, but I'm saying so on this show, you have to come back, because you know, we have some things to talk about that we haven't gone there. We haven't even gone there.
And sometimes, you know, sometimes I feel like stress. But you see, when you're trying to create an awareness in life for people, you have to set a good example.
Yeah.
It's not necessarily that I don't want to get married, but you know, when the fear of getting in there, I was never married, but the relationship was really tight. But I think that God knows best and he's going to direct me.
What do you think? I'm going to get married. All the messages that, I mean, I told you we are going to vets, and then I will do the vet and I'll just submit.
Tax collector.
That's correct, sir. Dzifa, do you want to go over the number again?
You say, Kwame, like, mean please. Kwame, my dear brother, mimpento kwa. Why? Mimpento kwa. Kwame, hami wo studio, hante maka. But yes, I mean, you can send me WhatsApp messages on 020-241-6658. My producer is looking at me and doing this. But maka.
Waka. She said it. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for sending in your views. Thank you for all the blessings. Thank you for all the compliments. It's really appreciated. I'm speaking on my own behalf and on the behalf of my sister. Dzifa, we are ending the show.
Wow. So soon.
I always enjoy her. Dylan, we are ending the show. Do you want to end the show for me by telling them to have a lovely week?
Okay, let me help you, okay?
Yes.
So this is what you say. Thank you so much for watching. They're on the couch. Or say thank you so much for watching.
Thank you so much for watching.
And we love you.
And we love you.
And this is the best show in the whole wide world.
And this is the best show in the whole world.
And keep watching.
And keep watching.
Pan-African.
Pan-African.
We love you.
We love you.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. With a smile. Look at them and smile. Do this. Aww. Blow them kisses. Blow them kisses.
Bye.
Bye.